We shall learn how to integrate jqplots with MVC so that the chart you saw just now, it is derived from database. These figures are stored in database and from there the chart is plotted. This will give you a very powerful edge when presenting reports using inside an MVC application. For this we shall use there is a library available, jqplot. We shall use that library and we shall start step by step. We shall first of all download the library and then we shall study it and finally integrate it with MVC. This is the website jqplot.com, jqplot.com. And here you'll find home, examples, docs, download, info, donate and all. So this is one of the best websites using charts. You can plot a variety of charts here. And let us now see what is in the download section. So here we'll find these downloads are listed by date. This is the release of 27th March. This is zip, GZ, BZ2, so they are available in various packages. For Windows we can use this zip. So you'll download this package and bring it to your desktop and let us see what it contains. Then we shall proceed further. So here it is. Go to jqplot.com. It is jqplot.com. So when I download it and extract it to my desktop, I get a folder dist inside it. Double clicking it, I find docs, examples, plugins and some of the files are there. We go to the examples and here we can find our bar line animated. These are some of the examples that are given to us. Clicking it, it opens the same chart. So now we'll try to understand what this chart is and how it has been probably brought here, and then we'll begin our in this chart we are seeing an x-axis 2002 2003 4 5. This is for the years. Then for each year you have one value for the line chart and one value for the bar chart. So both these charts are plotted on the same graph. So if the year is 2002, you will get one value for the bar chart, maybe $10,200, 1 lakh something. So there is a 3 coordinates available for each chart, each bar or what you call, each item, second item, third item. So for each you have 3 values. One is the year, the second is the value for the line and one is value for the bar. And if we go to scroll downwards, then this is the jQuery that they have written here. So here what they say is that you should get your data in a where called S1, 2002, 112, 000, 2003. So there is a one where called S1. It is declared here and this is the semicolon for it. There is another variable for S2 and this is the semicolon for it. So these are the two variables that we have. S1 is for the line chart, then this one is for the bar chart. For the line chart the values are like this, square bracket, first coordinate,